Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will start with the same chapter, weather and climate. In the last lecture we have studied about the difference between the weather and climate. Today we are going to study about the factors that determine the climate. There are five factors that determines the climate. First one is distance from the equator. Second one, height above the sea level. Third one, distance from the sea. Fourth one, direction of winds. And fifth one, humidity. Let us start one by one. The first one is the distance from the equator. Sun has a major influence on the climate of a place. Earth gets heated by the sun rays. Sun rays falls vertically near the equator. But as we move towards the pole, as we move away from the equator, the sun rays falls slantingly near the poles. So the areas near the equator are hotter than the places which are away from the equator, that is near the poles. Now children, different parts of the world get different amount of heat, and so we have different type of climate in different parts of the world. Some of the regions are very hot, some of the regions are very cold throughout the year. Now why do we see this different type of climate in the different areas? Because there are two reasons why do we have these differences. First one is the angle of the sun rays falling in that area, and second one is the shape of our earth. So children, this is the reason why the places which are away from the equator are less hotter than the places which are near the equator, because the areas which are near the equator receives the extreme heat, that is the vertical rays of the sun, which keeps that area extremely hot. Second one is the height above the sea level. The height of a place above the sea level is called the altitude. As we go higher, the temperature decreases and it makes that area more cooler. Now children, any village, city or place is located above the sea level. But the places are located at the different altitudes. So during summer vacation, we like to visit the hill stations like Shimla, Manali, Darjeeling, Mussoorie. Why? Because these places are very cold. And so mostly people visit during the summer vacation. Because why these places are very cold? Because they are located at the higher altitude. So as we go higher, the temperature decreases and the places are more cooler than the places which are at the lower altitude. So children, this is the factor which affects the climate of a place. Now the Now, one more example which is given in your textbook is about the Chennai and the Bangalore. Now, Chennai and Bangalore both are located at the same altitude. Chennai and Bangalore both are located at the same latitude. But Bangalore is more cooler than Chennai. Why? Because Bangalore is located at 3,100 feet above the sea level and Chennai is located mostly at the sea level. And because Bangalore is located at the higher altitude, it is more cooler than the Chennai. So is it clear that the places which are located at the higher altitude, what is altitude? Altitude is the height of a place above the sea level. So higher the altitude, cooler is the place. So this is the second factor which affects the climate. The third one is the distance from the sea. The places which are near the sea are neither too hot nor too cold. Means they have equable or moderate climate. Means they are neither too hot nor too cold. But the places which are away from the sea have the extreme type of climate. In your test book, they have given the example of Mumbai and Delhi. Now, Mumbai is located near the Arabian Sea, and so Mumbai has the moderate type of climate and Delhi has the extreme type of climate, because Mumbai is near the sea coast and Delhi is located away from the sea coast. Now, why do the places near the sea have the moderate type of climate? Because of the land breeze and the sea breeze. Now let us study what are land breeze and what are sea breeze. In the day, sun heats both the land and the sea, but the land heats up very quickly than the sea. And you know, children, the hot air is lighter than the cold air. So the warm air from the land rises up and blows towards the sea, and the cool air from the sea to take its places. This is called the sea breeze. At night, opposite happens. The land cools down faster than the sea. Sea cools down slowly. Now, the warm air from the sea rises and come towards the land, and the cool air from the land move towards the sea. This is called the land breeze. Due to the land breeze and the sea breeze, the climate of the places near the sea remains moderate. Now the fourth point, let us study about the, now the fourth point is the direction of the winds. Now the winds also influence the climate of a place, and wind may be hot, cold or moist depending on the place from which they blows. When they blow from the hot region, it makes the climate hot. Like for example, when the winds blow from the hot area like Rajasthan, it makes the climate hot. And when the winds blow from the cold region like Jammu and Kashmir, it makes the climate cool. Cold winds from the Himalayas makes the climate of the northern India more cooler. And monsoon winds also bring the rainfall with them. The winds from the sea make the climate cool and moist. And this way, the direction of the winds affects the climate of a place. Now the last one is the humidity. What is humidity? The amount of the moisture in the air is called humidity. Humid air affects the climate of a place and also brings the rainfall. Now the coastal areas are humid because the winds blowing from the sea bring lot of moisture with them, which makes the climate humid. And rainfall also affects the climate of a place. Because of the rainfall, the climatic condition changes. Now, the colder regions have the snowfall, and that is why the places near the sea, such as Mumbai and Chennai, are very humid. So this is about the humidity. So students, today we have studied about the factors that determines the climate. How does the distance from the equator affects the climate of a place? How does the height of a place above the sea level affects the climate? Then the place, whether it is near the sea or far away from the sea, that is the distance of a place from a sea, also affects the climate. Then the direction of the winds, that is the winds which blow from the hot region and the winds that blow from the cold region also affects the climate. And the last one, that is the humidity. How does the humidity affects the climate? So this is about the factors that determines the climate. Friends, read the lesson thoroughly and try to understand the concept. In the next lecture, we will move towards another topic. Thank you.